My first inclination when presented with this much rock is to go for the big stuff, get some large flakes from those nodules. But I've never worked hornstone before, actually. I've worked some cobden, which is its cousin, pretty much the same thing, I think, forms in round cannonball-like formations. So I think I'll save the big stuff for later and get started with some of these smaller ones, get them biface down first. I'll finish them up later and do those large ones. So I'll just start picking them up one by one and get them biface down, mostly using small hammer stones with some freehand antler thrown in. This will be pretty much just a direct percussion stage, bifacing down spalls and large flakes down into nice regular bifaces with continuous edges all around. Let's go from left to right, starting with this little beauty. Don't know if that'll cause any issues. Large quartz pocket right there. Some more quartz. It's a beautiful rock. Let's see what it looks like once it's bifaced out. I'll probably show you most of this work at double speed. All the preparation and small work anyways. The larger flakes I'll do at regular speed. Okay, here we go. Sorry about the noise. Of course, now is when the neighbor starts doing something loud. Hope you can see that all I did was take away the sharp edges, set up some platforms that I'll abrade and shape a little bit to take some flakes off. I can take some here to flatten that out. A couple here, hopefully, to flatten this back end out. Once that's done, I can reshape this edge and come back that way. That one deserves a close-up. Look at that lovely flake. That was so helpful. Finally got rid of this mess right there. Flattens that out nicely. Look at all the colors and the patterns in this stone. It works so well too. This is some of the nicest stone I've ever had my hands on, I think. Amazing. There's the platform. Technically an overface flake. Didn't overshoot. That quartz crystal in there probably stopped it. Well, it's a little sloppy still. This edge is pretty good. This one's still pretty irregular. That's as far as I'm gonna go with direct percussion though. So that's it for this video. I'll finish this thing out with indirect percussion and pressure flaking at a later stage. For now, let's move on to the next biface.